Hey guys, just real quick, I'm going to show you a little bit about the spawn system for game devs. You're going to want to get familiar with return all spawn locations, but for just adding spawns, spawn packs manually or through R packs, this is what you're going to want to do. So this system's pretty robust. You can actually do it a variety of different ways. The most preferred way is through an RPAC, of course, but if you're just testing in here and generate custom spawns, you can make your own logic. I'm gonna show you first about the RPAC. So RPACs load in default, they always load in the default set once. This will always be the default unless you specify otherwise, which you can do in playlists, and I'll show you later about that. But basically every RPAC is named pretty much the same format. You have always starts out with FS spawns playlist, and then we have the map name and then set number, which the set number is just to help these packs be unique, because every pack has to be a unique name. And obviously you might want more packs than just one set of spawns for this playlist, this map name. You can also override playlist in the playlist file, so you could choose to always load 1v1, and you can also set it in script logic if you need to. Like, I think that's a perfectly ample example. And anyways, so if you wanted to actually do some custom logic, you could if you were just testing, but this is not the preferred place to put it. You could put custom spawns, and you could make it's basically an array of lock pair. So you would just add your lock pair here, right? Now you have two custom locations that are going to be added to the spawn list. Okay. And if you know anything about 1v1, you would know that it's a good thing I put two here, because they should always be even. You should always have player A, player B in that whole list. But anyways, you have much more control over that in this callback function here. And this is add callback Flowstate spawns init. This is going to be what you want to put in your init section whenever you want to define a function to handle what happens after spawns load up. So the RPACs load in, all the spawns load in. Now, boom, this function loads in next, and it says, hey, this is the spawns I want to either overwrite with, extend, or maybe I want to change the waiting area. Maybe I want to change the panel area, okay? This is what you're going to use. And so we'll go ahead and add our own. We're going to call add callbacks, and we're going to say my spawn, okay? My spawns with an S. Okay, now we're going to take this, and we're going to look. I think I already have quite a few here. If you see init LG duels is an easy one. All I did was create a panel location that I wanted. I want this panel location to load when LG duels is on. So we look back over here, and what's the condition? Well, map name is this map, playlist is LG duels. So we're going to fire this function when the spawns load in. This function says, hey, here's my panel location. Okay, it's a lock pair. I named it panels, and this is the coordinates. Now I'm going, this function, this lock pair data function that you add as a callback should always return a lock pair data object. Now this function creates that for you. So all you have to do is pass in what you want, and it returns it. When spawns load in, this function gets called. Magic happens. Pottery. Okay. So the first parameter is an array of spawn locations. If I wanted to have, like I showed you over here, an array of spawn locations, I would put them here. And then you would define what happens with those. The behavior is either true, they override all the spawns, or false, they do not, they extend the list. So it's like extra spawns. Like if you can see right here, I did that exact thing. I added some spawns to drop off, which is like the spawns that we worked on with remap. And then we have the third parameter, which is your custom waiting room. And then the fourth parameter, which is your custom panels. Now, if these are null, they do nothing. I mean, if it's empty array, nothing happens. But obviously, I wanted panels load here. So that's how that init function works. But the thing is, you don't want to have to manually add these in here. So what I've done is I've created a cool system here where you can actually go into like what map you want, and you can go to dev default, and you can make your own spawns very, very quickly. So what do we have here? While that's loading in, we're going to go ahead and lock pair data. function my spawns. Remember, we made a callback already. And now we need something in it, right? We know it returns this, right? We know it returns this. What do we want? We're just gonna make some spawns. So we'll leave that empty and we'll figure out that in just a minute. What we're gonna do is we're gonna come in here, okay? We're gonna say, let's get script started, and we're gonna do dev position help. This is gonna give us a list of commands here, and you can see position type. Basically, you want to pass in either CSV or squirrel. You can switch back and forth between these at will. It's going to change the whole array, and it's going to affect the output that you output into this folder right here, which I'll show you soon. So when we're making our file, we want to first start out with position type. Okay. First thing we do is we set CSV or squirrel. I'm going to do CSV just because it doesn't matter. I can switch back and forth. And then I'm going to go ahead and, I mean, I'm ready to rock, right? I'm ready to add my spawns. Enough crap. Let's go ahead and put the add spawn command in there, and I'm going to put my name because that's where it starts, okay? So as, oh, I actually didn't want that spawn there. That's not a good spawn. So what do we do? We're going to do delete position. Actually, let's see what we have. Let's go ahead and do print position array, okay? So we see that we have a spawn there. I don't like that. We're gonna delete position. I don't want that. I made a mistake. It's supposed to be a function call here. Okay, so now there's none in there. Perfect. So now we can get started what we were trying to do, which is add spawns. So say I wanna add my awesome spawns. Actually, I wanna fight up here. Why not? You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Maybe I like it over here. Maybe this is a good one, right? This is the best spawn in the world. So I'm gonna add one here. We're gonna add one here. Okay, we're going to our next spawn, and I didn't mean to add that third spawn. That's fine. What we'll do is we'll see what we got. We come here, print position array. Okay, we have set 1, 0, and 1. Yeah, 2, I messed up 1. How do I know? Let's see, where does 2 take me to? Dev, teleport to position, teleport who, teleport me, teleport to what, position 2. Oh, teleport to position, not TP. Okay, so now, yeah, I don't want that. I did not want that there. I could delete that, or I could just overwrite that one with this one. And so what we'll do, back up here to add spawn, and we'll replace 2 with that. So now 2 is there, and if we teleport the 2 again, you'll see that there's 2. So let's go ahead and add our last spawn that we're going to put in this pack. That's a terrible spot. Let's do it right here. All right. Perfect, right? This is where I want. So now we're going to add a spawn without anything. Perfect, right there. Now let's see what we got. Right, we have set 1, set 2. We have 4 spawns. That's plenty. That's all we need. That's the best spawns in the world. So what we're gonna do is, right now it's in CSV, but I kind of want it in squirrel because I'm gonna put it right in to test it out. So we're gonna go ahead and do the squirrel. Okay, and now it's in squirrel code. And then we're gonna go ahead and do, if you forget what it is, you can do position help, and it's gonna show you a function call. It's going to show you that you can do right position out. Okay. And what we're going to do is check and see where that went to. It's 624.nut. And so we come into our files here and we see R5Reloaded platform output. We have 624 right here. And cool, it's already got the code I need. And so now we'll go back into our little function we had here. I'm going to paste that right in, right? I don't like the way that's positioned. So now we have our spawns. And this is the spawns that we chose. Then we have our return statement here, which is going to return a lock pair object, which is just a lock pair data object, okay? But we need to pass it, like I said, the first thing is always the array of spawns, so we're going to put in spawns. Second thing is whether or not to override. And you know what? I'm going to override, because my spawns are so much better than the default spawns, I don't need them. I don't need a default waiting room area, and I don't need a panel coordinates. I don't need to mess with any of that. All I want to do is make my beautiful spawns be the main ones. So now that we've done that, right, we've added all that juicy stuff in, we're going to go ahead and go to 1v1 mode. Okay. We're going to go ahead and load it up. See what happens. So spawns overridden with custom spawns count 4. Cool. So our custom spawns are overriding the default that we had in there. And for good reason, they're just amazing, right? We're gonna go ahead and add a bot in here so we can try these awesome spawns out. We're gonna get this message out of my face. Never seen that. Oh, I was already in it. Let me fight. Perfect. Look at these spawns. Oh my gosh, so good. All right, this guy is literally in the invisible wall. So that's why it was the best spawn. That's perfect. So I guess those aren't the spawns to keep then, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna make a brand new set of spawns. And these ones are gonna be even better than before. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and get our types at the SQ. We're gonna get this message out of our face. We're gonna add a spawn here. We're gonna add our other spawn here because it's so good. All right, I think that's enough of that. I think we should go. I think we don't get enough of these. So we're gonna do one here, right? We're gonna do one here, right? Okay. It's perfect. Okay, so now we have, what do we have? We have four. That's perfect, right? Do we need much more? Those are pretty boring. Those are old spawns. Like, what do we have over here? What's over here? Nothing. How about down here? This is awesome. So now we're going to add spawn here. Around, and we're going to add spawn here. Okay, now we're pretty much settled, right? That's what we want. We're going to go ahead and make this into an R-Pak. So we want this to be CSV. And now we want to write this out. Okay, and now it's 897.csv. We come over here, check 897. That looks amazing. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take this, okay? We're going to go into repak here. If you have this downloaded, we're going to go into depot data table. Okay, and we already have set one and set two. So what we're going to do is we're going to we're just going to paste it right in. Boom. And I'm going to copy this to make my life much easier. We're going to name it set three. And we have three amazing spawn sets. Let's go into here, and we're not going to even pack that one. We're going to pack three only. Okay. So we're going to save that. We're going to drag this on top here. We're going to see that we have a new file. Okay, we're going to copy this. We're going to close out of R5 Reloaded. It's fine. We don't worry about that. R5 Reloaded, we're going to go to packs 164. We're going to paste our new pack directly in. And now we're going to configure. We're going to go over here because it's a custom spawn. We got to make sure that we tell the game, hey, it's okay to use that spawn, that pack. That pack is good for production. My server is ready to host it, and everybody that joins my server is definitely should play on these spawns because they're amazing. So we're going to go ahead and enable three. So we have one and three enabled. In fact, it's so good, we're going to enable sets, and we're going to enable the prefer option, and we're going to set the best spawns to be used, right? Because my spawns are just top of the line, bro. They're just... can't get much better than them spawns. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and start it up. We're gonna go in and we're gonna go to hosting, and we're gonna go back to our beloved aqueduct. Okay, and we should see here when it loads up the map. Beautiful. So what do we have here? Spawn pack has set to three, and it's got the best spawns in the game loaded up. Let's get somebody in here to showcase that, right? Let's get man in. Man's always ready to show down. Perfect, right? Very interesting how it's giving me the same spawn. Surely there's other spawns, right? There we go. Perfect. Best spawns in the game. Now, at the same time, this is not enough spawns, so you know what? Maybe I don't want to load that pack, you know? Maybe I want to go ahead and, you know, I could do random if it was a good pack. You know what this is more for, since it's only a few spawns? I think the best thing to do would be to not use sets. And what we do is we just set this function. we set it to extent. By putting false, we now add these spawns to the default pack, right? And so what we can do here, oh, I should probably reload the playlist. It's gonna still load packs. But now, basically having done that, now we can see that it's loading the main pack, and then it's extending it with our custom spawns, right? And so that's pretty much a little bit of the control that you have, and there's more control, there's more options that you can do by like overriding the spawn pack to the specific spawn pack that you want. You can use that in game logic, you can use that in playlist logic. You can do a lot of different things with this, as well as rotate and pick random packs and enable packs by numbers, whatever you want, for the map, for each map. So that's pretty much how that works.